Blackstone presents Big Easy Trouble by Charles Tillman. This book is read by Chelsea Stevens. Prologue. Dixieland Amusement Park, New Orleans, Louisiana. A blood moon hung low in the sky over the abandoned park. The skeletal remains of damaged amusement rides stood as silent sentinels over the weeds and rotting buildings that littered the park grounds. Alert eyes watched unseen as their unsuspecting prey bumbled through the dilapidated facility.
"Come on, Trisha, it's just up ahead," Lindsay called over her shoulder.
"Damn it, Linz, slow down. I can't see a damn thing, and I don't want to step on no damn cottonmouth. What the hell's so important anyway?"
"You'll see. Hurry up."
Lindsay laughed as she disappeared around the corner of an old concession stand.
"I can't believe I let you talk me into this shit. We should be eating beignets and drinking coffee in the quarter now instead of wandering around in the damn swamp at night."
Trisha came around the falling down building and staggered to a stop with a loud shriek when a bright light came to life and blinded her.
"Surprise!"
several voices yelled.
"Oh, damn, what the hell? You damn near made me pee myself,"
Trisha squeaked as her friends gathered around singing happy birthday.
"We wanted to have your birthday early since you're going to be at that tournament in Shreveport on the day,"
Lindsay laughed after they finished the song.
"Millie and Ronnie thought it'd be fun to have your party out here this year since we did last year's in Lafayette Cemetery. She thought having this one in a dead amusement park would be a fitting follow-up."
"Oh, do you plan to get me arrested this year, too?"
Trisha asked with false innocence.
"Oh, poo. The cute cop let you go with a warning when Ronnie explained it was your birthday and we weren't vandals or freaks,"
Millie scoffed.
"I don't know," Lindsay drawled. "I think he hoped he'd get freaky with Ronnie's bodacious bosom before the night was out. I've never seen her whip her bra off faster."
"Yeah, I don't think the poor guy could form a complete sentence after she blasted him with both barrels from under that sheer shirt she had on."
Millie's laugh cut off abruptly with a strangled gasp. She stared behind Trisha with her mouth open and the whites of her eyes showing. Trisha began,
"What is—"
An ear-shattering howl shattered the night. The girls jumped and frantically searched the dark surrounding them for the source of the sound. Millie's flashlight beam jerked around futilely, ruining what little night vision the group had. Ronnie screamed as a shadowy shape sprang from the night, leaving her crumpled on the debris-covered asphalt as it disappeared into the darkness.
"Ronnie? Ronnie, what's wrong?"
Lindsay cried. A deep, rumbling growl cut through the night, freezing them in their tracks. Soon, more growls came from all around, followed by the girls' terrified screams. Minutes later, the only sounds in the park were the noises of the native frogs and insects. They resumed slowly and grew louder as more creatures joined in once they sensed the group of apex predators depart. 1. Treme, New Orleans, Louisiana.
"Welcome, Master Bordelon, Mistress Greymont. Mistress Marie awaits in the front parlor,"
Austin intoned in his rough, lifeless voice.
"That's just weird," Natalia whispered to Matt.
"You get used to it. Austin's been here all my life, and I barely notice his—"
Matt searched for a word.
"Peculiarities."
"He still gives me the creeps. I looked at his eyes the first time I met him, and I swear I saw awareness in them. It's like he's there, but not really."
Natalia shuddered.
"He's in there, all right. Tante Marie once told me that he's conscious in the body, but can only watch. The body follows her commands, no matter how hard he tries to resist. I'm sure he's crazy as a loon after over a century of living inside a body he can't control."
"That's, barbaric."
"Perhaps it is, child. But what he did to earn his punishment was horrific. Isn't that right, Austin?"
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.